time for baseball in the Bay Area as we welcome you to the Oakland Coliseum. Tonight, an intriguing matchup between the Chicago Cubs and the New York Mets. It's baseball, it's the show, and it comes your way next. Now to the plate, here is number 66. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Count is 2-1.
Wow, third pitch of the game. That looked like a pretty good pitch. If that's called a ball, it could be a rough night for the pitchers tonight.
And he lays off ball four, and the leadoff man is on to begin the ball game. The next Cub up, number 18. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. Working for the punch out and the offering. And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside. 3-2. There's a drive high in the air and deep to left center field. Gone! Into the box, Ian Happ. Fouled away. And another foul ball. To first. Reined in. Throw on to first, so a good comeback there as he gets the first out of the inning.
That is cool.
So bases are empty with one gone, and Wilson Contreras digs in at the plate. The 1-2.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Hit in the air down the left field line. Back goes McNeil. He gets there, and that's the second out. So in now for Chicago, Patrick Wisdom.
Number 16.
The 2-2. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. Stepping up is Jonathan Villar. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Ball three as the sinker misses just off the black that time. His matchup numbers with Hendricks. He's got 5 base hits in 22 tries. He's taken him deep once and then misses for ball four. So an early base runner in the bottom half as they're trying to get one or both of those runs right back. Here's the 2-2. Line to the right side. And that's in there. Base hit. He'll hold it second, and there are two aboard now.
That is good. That's your job.
Standing in now, Francisco Lindor. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way.
Put that in a memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Here he comes again. 1-2. VR over at second. Nimmo on at first with nobody out. 2 balls and 2 strikes to count to Francisco Lindor.
Number 3 hole hitter up right now. Cleanup guy on deck. 2-ball, 2-strike count. I think pitcher wants to make something happen right here.
And he indeed takes only the out at first as the runners move to second and third with one away now. And next will be the Mets cleanup hitter, Pete Alonso. Base knocked to the outfield could score the tying run from second.
That's
3-1.
And remember here, there's an open base at first, so a walk is not the worst thing that could happen right here.
And he drops a change in on him there, and that'll run it full 3-2. one that misses ball four, so that'll load him up, but at least the double play is in order here with one away. Striding in is Michael Conforto, trying here to plate the tying run from second. And this misses, so it'll set up a big pitch coming up. It's full 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it.
And the throw to first is there. The inning is over. New inning set to get underway, and set to go is the second baseman, Matt Duffy.
I'm interested to see how focused their ABs will be playing with this lead. I think this needs to be a little bit of a smell blood in it. Keep the fire rolling. I know it's early, but keep the pressure going. Swinging the bat's nice.
We got 3-2.
Ball three. 3-2 now.
He walked a guy back in the first, and now he's looking like he might hand out another free pass to the leadoff guy here. You can't be walking a guy an inning and think you're going to have any success.
Can't connect there. It's 2-2.
Hey, you know the pitcher right now. He's looking for that best friend, that double play ball. This is where you have to really be disciplined at the plate and make sure that you get a pitch that's above the knees that you can get in the air.
3-2 now. There's a swing and a high drive into left center field. Back goes McNeil. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Now at the plate, number 43. First swings for him in this one, with a runner still at first and one gone. Swing and a miss, strike two.
Hey, you know in the back of your mind as a batter right here, he's got that nasty sinker. I know it's 0-2, but he might not be looking for the punch out. You have to find a way as a batter to get that two-seamer up in the zone, or you're going to ground into a double play.
Ready with another 2-2. Runners on first with one down. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going.
Hey, have an AB right here. I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
The 2-2. Fouled off. Full count now, 3-2.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Into the corner and slicing foul. Payoff pitch one more time. And he finally wears him down as he strikes him out after a prolonged battle. That was good stuff. The pitcher. Runner at first with two gone. And the pitcher, Kyle Hendricks, will be the next to bat. 1-1. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Giving chase is Nimmo. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And next, the dangerous power threat, Javier Baez. Here now the 2-2. Gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And there's out number one. Next to the Mets, Jeff McNeil. One out, nobody on. Just hung in there on that one. There's a base hit on the line. So now to the plate, James McCann. 2-2 to the Mets catcher.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
On the first, and that's two innings and two double plays they've hit into so far as the inning is over. And stepping in, number 66. No official at bat for him, but he has scored a run in this one. The 1-1. Swing and a liner. A leap here, but it ticks off his glove. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely. At the plate now, number 18. And opposite field as he lines this down the line and right. And this will find the wall deep in the corner. The relay, but he'll be in there with a double. Stepping in now, Ian Happ shatters the bat as this is hit on the ground. He's got it. And indeed, he'll take only the out at first as the run comes in to score. Next to hit will be Wilson Contreras. 0 for 1 here in the early going. The 1-1 home. Timing just a tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Again, a 1-2. Slider laid off for a ball.
Great game plan so far by this offense. They're not chasing any of those breaking balls out of the zone.
Hit softly down the line at first. Throw gets him two down. Next to stand in is Patrick Wisdom, who went down on strikes in his last at bat. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Seventh pitch of the at bat coming up. That's down low. It's ball four. And they're at the corners now with two away.
The batter number five.
Next, it'll be Matt Duffy. Two on, two out for him here in the third. Stroman comes set. 1-1 on its way. One and two is the changeup had him out in front there. Hit hard to short. Fielded cleanly. They'll go to Baez at second for the force, and that ends the inning. Leading off the inning, it'll be Marcus Stroman as they'll look to spark the offense and even things up. Now the 1-1 pitch. Grounded to short. And that's the first out. So one man gone for the Mets in the third. And the switch hitter Jonathan Villar will be the next to bat. 1-1. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. But that'll hit off the wall in left center. And he's in there easily at second with a one out double.
Now back. The seventh fielder. Brandon Nimmo.
Into the box now. Brandon Nimmo. Nimmo with an even count of 2-2 now. This is pulled into right. And that's taken in straightaway right. Will he try from second? So a man at second here with two away. That'll bring up the switch hitting shortstop and perennial MVP candidate Francisco Lindor. Well out in front of the breaking ball there for a strike.
Offered at that breaking ball below the zone, and that's a tough one to spit on. But the key is recognizing it coming out of the pitcher's hand earlier, making sure that it goes up before it comes down. More likely to be a hanger when that's the case.
And here's a curveball that's laid off that time. It's full 3-2. High fly ball out to straightaway center. number 66. Find some space out there for the catch to retire the side. All set for the start of the fourth, and next will be the speed threat, Nico Hoerner. Now the 3-2 pitch. Pitch is popped up. Alonso in foul ground, and that's the first out of the inning. Now it'll be number 43. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. Both clubs with three hits in the ball game. Now a swing, and he pops him up. This is right out in front of the mound. Stroman take charge himself out there, and there's two down.
Now back.
So here now is the pitcher, Kyle Hendricks. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. 1-1 pitch and a good sinker there, but he can't find the zone. 2-1.
It's one thing to get hit around, but it's far worse when you're getting yourself into trouble by not throwing strikes. Every pitcher's been there, but it doesn't make it any less frustrating or unacceptable.
Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And next to bat will be the first baseman, Pete Alonso. Nearly got the inside, but ruled a ball.
This guy's been throwing the ball great so far, but it's going to be tested here. 4, 5, and 6 coming up this part of the lineup.
And it's fouled away. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full.
Hey, throwing the ball great up until this point. Don't want to allow a leadoff walk. Needs to just focus in on his mechanics right here.
Made a miss on the off-speed pitch that time. Pete Alonso is dealt with for the first out in the bottom of the inning. Here's a swing and a shot back up the middle. And that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit.
Now back, second baseman, Javier.
To the plate now, Javier Baez. The second for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Trevor Williams, a right-handed reliever standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen.
Trevor.
And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. The 1-2. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Conforto is there, and he'll bring this one in. Next to hit is number 18. Already a home run and a double for him in this one. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Into right field. That's a base hit.
The left fielder, number 8, Ian Happ.
Into the box, Ian Happ. And he fouls this one off. Here comes the 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. So it's a runner at first with two gone. And stepping up to hit next, the catcher Wilson Contreras. 1-2.
I got the count.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
3-2 now.
Good running count right here. 3 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs, runner on first. He'll be off to the races on this pitch.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. He's set. Here's the 3-2.
Nope.
And a good at bat that time as he lays off for ball 4. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with 2 away. And he lays off again, ball 3.
3-1 here, you have to make a good pitch on the mound. Grooving one here rarely works in your favor unless the hitter tries to do too much with it.
Into right field, that's a base hit. He'll come home with it. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
Now back the second baseman, Matt.
At the plate, Matt Duffy. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, and this is going to wind up a foul ball. The 3-2 one more time is swung on and missed. He got him. Of the inning now, and standing in the outfielder, Jeff McNeil. Swing line drive. That's going to be trouble. Around first, he's digging for second. At the plate now, James McCann. Off to the right side, should get the runner to third. Scooped up, throw on to first in time, one away. Luis Guillorme will grab a bat and pinch hit now, and he'll be looking for at least a fly ball as he's got a runner at third and only one away.
Guillorme.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Hit to short. Reined in. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score. So it's back to the top of the order now. And the switch hitter, Jonathan Villar, will be the next to bat. Down low, 2 balls and a strike. Shot down the line. It's a fair ball. He's around first, heading for 2. And now he'll get into scoring position with 2 away.
Left center fielder, number 9, Brandon.
Standing in now, Brandon Nimmo. Drilled right back up the middle. Oh, beautiful dive. Touché, sir. Seth Lugo takes over to start the 6th inning on the mound.
Now pitching for the New York Mets.
All set for the start of the inning, and stepping up is the shortstop, Nico Horner. A ball and 2 strikes. Here's the pitch. To 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2.
And just when you needed a shutdown inning, a leadoff walk was certainly not on the agenda. He needs a bear down right here.
Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. And now in the box, number 43. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far. All even now, 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Weak grounder back to the mound. in time to first, and there are two away. Two away now for the Cubs in the sixth, and the pitcher Kyle Hendricks will be the next to bat. Four runs, five hits, no errors so far for the Cubbies. Cubs pitcher at the plate trailing with a 1-2 count. Filthy changeup that time, but he's able to make contact and he'll get another chance.
He's certainly pushing the throttle and pulling it with those four pitches.
But we'll have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and that'll bring up the switch hitting shortstop, Francisco Lindor. The 2-1 home. Hit out towards second. He's got it. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out. One away now for the Mets in the sixth, and up steps the power bat of Pete Alonso. Two balls and a strike. Sixth inning, 4-1 is our score. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Right side hit hard, and that is through into right field for a single.
The right fielder, number 30, Michael.
Stepping in now, Michael Conforto. Very weakly on the ground. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball.
Nope.
Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball.
Keep in mind, people, the longer the at-bat, the higher the likelihood that this becomes his last inning.
Spoils another one, and we'll do it again. The 2-2 pitch. Fastball is outside, and it's full down, 3-2.
He's definitely going to want to get greedy in his zone, and he's obviously seeing the ball well, or he would have swung at that pitch. Sometimes in these long, epic at-bats, you start to get into swing mode.
Once again, a 3-2. Fouled away.
You can visibly see the body language of this guy on the mound is completely changed during this at bat. Six foul balls has to be completely frustrating him that he can't put him away.
Number 43 is there, and he makes the catch for the out. And that brings up Javi Baez. 0-2 on his line thus far.
Baez.
1-2, here it comes. Weighing inside with that one, a pretty easy take there. Line towards center field, and that'll get down for a base hit. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double. Adbert Alzale comes on now looking for the final out of the inning to strand the two runners in scoring position.
Number 73, Adbert.
In now, Jeff McNeil saws him off here as this ball's popped into the air, and he'll avoid the fragments out there to make the catch that ends the inning. Now to bat, number 66. He enters this at bat, 1-for-2 with a walk. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down. Stepping in next, number 18. And he's got a shot at history here, but he'll need a triple to complete the cycle. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out. Into the box, Ian Happ struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
And take a good look there as this misses for ball four, and the Cubs have themselves a two-out base runner. So it's a runner at first with two men out, and Wilson Contreras digs in at the plate. Here's the 1-1.
Count is two.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch, but if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
2-2 to the Cubs catcher.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that front foot down early and get ready, or he's going to throw it right by you.
This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. Last half of the seventh here, and now it'll be the catcher, James McCann. The 3-2 pitch. Full count still. Hit hard on the ground to second. And a good throw gets him one gone. Dominic Smith will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number two, Dominic Smith.
1-1.
Ball.
And that's down into left center for a base hit. Running hard, he's digging for second. And he'll pull into second with one away.
Third baseman, number one, Jonathan Villar.
To the plate now, Jonathan Villar. And it's full now, 3-2. And that misses ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning.
Rex Brothers comes on now, and this move will force the switch hitter to bat from the right side.
And I think that's exactly the thought process, Matt. He's not as strong of a hitter from the right side, so we'll see if this proves to be a smart move out of the pen.
Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
How about it?
So here's Francisco Lindor now. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Popped him up. Number 18 waits on it, and that will end the inning. Lee Hembree has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 53.
Stepping in once again is Patrick Wisdom. Singled homer run in his last time up. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now. Count still at 1-2. Now here it comes. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. And out of the plate, Matt Duffy. He went down on strikes last time up. 8th inning, 4-1 is our score. Squares up the slider that time, and it's into left center for a base hit.
Now back.
pitch now. Nico Horner got him on a good slider there. Swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight. So stepping in is number 43. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Seared down the first baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Fly ball out toward left center field. And McNeil will put it away to retire the side. Cody Hoyer will come on now and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Sergio Alcantara is into the ballgame as well as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch.
Ball
maybe
two.
Too much break on the slider. 2-1. Hit hard on the ground to second. Scooped up. Throw to first is in time for the first down. Next, here is Michael Conforto. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here.
Yeah, Matty, but as he walks to the plate right here, he feels good building off that last AB. He hit that ball on screws.
And a base hit into left field, so they've got themselves a one-out base runner.
Now back, second baseman.
At the plate now, Javier Baez tried to crush that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
Now
so the next to bat will be Jeff McNeil. In his last at bat, he popped out in foul ground. The 3-1 pitch, a bouncer up the middle, fielded cleanly, and he's safe. Into the box, James McCann. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
He's got a couple of pitches to deal with right here, but he's starting to lose command of his pitches. It might be time to take a step back and try to refocus on making some good pitches.
Here now the 2-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Set to start the ninth in this one. And coming forward now is the shortstop, Sergio Alcantara. Swing and a liner. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is aboard.
Now that, number 66.
At the plate, number 66.
Nope, at the
two
ball.
2-1. Here's a look over to first. Runner back standing. To short, hit hard. And that's through into left, and back-to-back singles have him in business to start the ninth. Stepping in now, number 18. To 2-2 now. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Conforto has the best view of this one, so he'll take it for the first down. Miguel Castro will come on now and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Jose Peraza will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hold in the order here on that double switch. Happ
ball
with
two.
A 2-1 count now.
We got two balls, one strike.
Three and one to the Cubs left fielder.
I love the approach out on the mound. Everything's down in the zone as it should be, but now you find yourself in a 3-1 count. Do you elevate a little bit more and get back in the zone, or do you just pitch around?
Count full, three balls and two strikes. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul. The next 3-2. Now here's a ball hit high and deep to straightaway right field. Going back is the right fielder, and it's off the scoreboard. Wow! To the plate now, Wilson Contreras.
That's ball two.
Now a sinker's low off the outside corner, two balls and a strike. His career numbers against this pitcher, he's 1-for-2. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Here now the 2-2. Doesn't get the zone, count full now. Patrick Wisdom is on deck. And you can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two.
Number 16.
Next, it'll be Patrick Wisdom grounded out in his last at bat. Now the payoff pitch home. And a changeup couldn't get him to bite, and it's ball four. Digging in will be Matt Duffy. Last time through was a base hit. Now a foul tip that's held onto with the plate, and the count moves to 1-2 now.
That was a great hack right there. Timing was on point. Just sometimes you have bad bat barrel accuracy.
Two balls and two strikes to Duffy. Now a swinging bunt. The 2-2 one more time. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. Three runs already home here. That misses, and it's going to set up a big pitch now. 3-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
Number 62.
And a swing and a miss. Does that look like self-defense there? It's 2-2.
Boy, that's a jam shot right there. That's as good as it gets, in my opinion. Woo! Up and in.
Sent on the ground out to second. Throw on to first, and they're able to escape the monster inning as the side is retired. Jason Adam is on, and he'll take over on the mound in relief.
Number 60. Jason.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. And digging into bat next, it'll be Jose Peraza. A ball and two strikes. Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away.
How about it?
Next up from New York, Jonathan Villar. He's got a couple of doubles thus far, so we'll see if he can keep it up. Now the 1-1 pitch. Sliced hard but foul. Here comes the 1-2. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out. At the plate now is Brandon Nimmo. He sat down on strikes in his last at bat.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
Taken called strike two, and now they're down to their final strike tonight. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes.
Nope, outside.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Lifted the other way down the left field line. Left fielder giving chase, and he tracks it down, and this ball game is over.
You might think it's just another win, but it's awfully hard to win in this game, especially on the road. But they find a way to get it done, and they should be very happy with this performance.
7-1, the final score in tonight. Chicago jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Kyle Hendricks earns the victory on the mound. Marcus Stroman was only able to work four innings as he takes the loss. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
Here now is the final line score tonight. First for the victorious Chicago Cubs. 7 runs on 9 hits. No errors. They left 9 runners on base. For the Mets, 1 run, 11 hits. No errors. They left 13 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 4 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.